Next on Prep Sports Plus, we have highlights of the state gymnastics championships. You'll be amazed when you hear about this brother and sister act. The Red Devils do the hokey pokey. We'll go around the bases with the Vikings. Defense is the name of the game for these young ladies, and this student athlete is our Academic Athlete of the Week. Prep Sports Plus is next.
Welcome to Georgia's only statewide high school sports and academics program, Prep Sports Plus. And by viewers like you. From the studios of GPTV in Atlanta, here's your host, Jim Giannacchio.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to our last spring show for 2002. I'm Jim Giannacchio. What an exciting time it is for graduating seniors statewide as they prepare for their final exams before graduation. This is also the time of the year when most of the extracurricular activities start to wind down, including a handful of sports. The question at the GHSA Gymnastics Championship was, can Roswell win their third straight title in a row? Brian Salmon has the answer from Westminster.
There's nothing like the graceful movement of a gymnast during a flawless floor routine or the explosive spring of a vault catapulting a competitor high into the atmosphere. How about watching a nail-biting performance on the balance beam? Or better yet, watching an almost elastic figure on the body-bending uneven bars? Well, if this wets your whistle, Westminster was a place to be May 3rd for the girls' 2001 Gymnastics Championships.
We had high-level competition coming in, and we organized it, and the girls came in, did a fantastic job with their routines, and I think it turned out to be a great night.
The Bars saw Oconee go home with first and second place medals. Wesley Freeman scored a 9.4, and her teammate, Callie Canfield, was right behind her with a 9.35.
Yeah, I was really surprised because I didn't think I would win, so yeah, I was really excited.
From there, it was pretty much the Roswell Durning Show. Whether it was Sarah or Megan, the ladies from Roswell completely dominated. In the floor exercise, Megan Durning scored a 9.75, wrapping up first place, while Oconee's Callie Canfield placed second with a 9.5.
My favorite event is probably floor. Yeah, I like performing, doing everything, it's great.
On probably the toughest event for the young ladies, the balance beam, this is where team titles are won and lost. Roswell's Megan Durning won with an amazing 9.8, running away from her nearest competitor, Kara Ferraro, of Lassiter High School, who scored a 9.275. The vault saw a familiar face walk away with the gold, Megan Durning, again. She scored another unbelievable 9.8. This time, she edges out Natalie Bavacqua of Colquitt County, who scored a 9.5.
Oh, it's been great. I couldn't be more happy. It's been awesome. I'm so excited.
So when the all-around award came around, it was no surprise that Roswell's Megan Durning was able to raise her hand in victory. But it was a surprise when her little sister Sarah was awarded second place in the all-around. And rounding things out, Colquitt's Natalie Bavacqua was third.
I really didn't know some of the places. Like Sarah Durning, I had no idea she had second place all around. That was a surprise to me. I knew Megan had won everything.
I did not think I was going to do this well, and it's relieving that I don't have to watch her anymore because I get more nervous watching her than when I go.
I'm very proud. I'm proud of all of the kids. And there's some other kids that are on other teams that train with us as well. So there were a bunch of kids out here that I work with that are I'm thrilled for all of them. They did great.
Last but not least, in the team competition, there wasn't a whole lot of suspense who the victor was. Roswell High earned their third straight team title, while Oconee took second and Lassiter won third.
This year made it a lot more like nerve-wracking because everyone like expects, you know, like the best from us. So we were all really nervous, but we pulled through.
With Roswell High School three-peating and the Durning sisters placing 1-2 in the all-around event, I had to do some snooping to find out just why they had so much spring in their step. I went through their gym bags and I found these. Now, I'm not saying anything, but this might have something to do with why they play so well. Reporting in Westminster for Prep Sports Plus, I'm Brian Salmon.
As Brian mentioned, it was the Durning sisters of Roswell leading the way. Megan scores just over 38 points, Sarah just over 37. Natalie Babakwa of Colquitt County was third, followed by Kara Ferraro of Lassiter. So when they tallied up all the final numbers, the Hornets finished first for the third straight year. It's also their fourth title in the last 6 years. Oconee County was second, followed by Lassiter, Colquitt County, and Milton. Congratulations to all the teams that participated at the state championships. Back in the 80s and early 90s, there was a commercial on television where an announcer would say, "Where's Loganville?" Oh, how times have changed, thanks in part to the Red Devils. As our Rob Tribble explains, the boys on the diamond have put their town back on the map. Now every team in AAA knows exactly where Loganville is.
Where's Loganville?
Well, actually, they are part of the upper crust of AAA. The Red Devils have won 21 straight, are 17-0 in the region, 22-3 overall, and ranked fourth in 3A, and pretty laid back about the whole thing.
We had a lot of guys back from a great team last year, and we had high hopes going in. The guys worked hard, and we felt like we would have a shot at winning the region. We never thought we'd win 20 straight games, but these guys have done a great job, worked real hard, and I'm real proud of them.
Are you guys that good, or is your schedule that weak? That's the question.
We have a tough region. We just played hard. Our first few games, we kind of squeaked it out barely, but we battled the whole game. We won a couple of those, and then we just kind of got on a roll.
Everything's starting to roll for us right now. Pitching, hitting, defense, everything. And that's about it.
The Red Devils aren't superstitious like many teams on a roll. Well, there is that one thing.
Put your right leg in, you put your right leg out, you put your right leg in, and you shake it all about. You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about.
What up,
I don't know, we kind of started last year and it seemed like we just got on a roll, and then before every game, right after our prayer, we just break out in the hokey pokey and pick a limb to put in there every now and then.
Pitcher Brandon Moss isn't the biggest guy on the field, but the 6 foot, 180 pounder has a big fastball. Moss has been clocked as high as 95 miles per hour. That's big time, big enough to make the University of Georgia signee a possible first-round pick. Oh, and he can hit, too. Moss is batting near 500 with 13 homers.
Are you signing if you do get drafted?
I don't know. I mean, it's a very good possibility. I really don't know. I have to talk to my parents and the Coach Perno and the scouts from the other team and stuff, see what's going on, you know, weigh the best option. Because, I mean, college, D1 college scholarship, that's a good thing to have, too, so.
Brandon's really worked hard in the weight room the last 4 years. He really took off after his sophomore year on the mound. He jumped probably 10 miles an hour.
It's about 12 to 10. He's giving up 12. I've given up 10. So.
You know, Hicks has been really bragging about having a lower ERA than you.
Don't listen to him. He'll lie to you in a second. I got a lower ERA than Hicks does any day. He can't hang. You tell him I said that.
Rob Tribble, Prep Sports Plus.
Coach Ryan, what's the indicator?
That would be none of your business. I'm sorry, I cannot share that information.
Oh, how about those Red Devils? All right, thanks, Rob. Another baseball team having a very successful season is Lakeside. With more on the Vikings, here's Cindy Beaumont.
Now, lest you believe these Vikings peaked last year after going 22-4, look out. These guys are mostly juniors and have nowhere to go but up.
We've got a nice team. We work hard. We've got some nice set of senior players and a good group of juniors and some underclassmen that's fit in well. We feel like we've got good chemistry and some decent pitching, and I feel like we got a solid team.
We've done pretty good. We started off a little rough, had a couple losses early, but we had a couple key players that were on the basketball team, and then they got back after playoffs, and we started to get on a little roll. And we played good region ball and clinched the first seed in the region.
We were missing our first baseman and third baseman at the beginning, and so we got off to a slow start. But once we got them back, it took a little bit to get everything going well. But right now, we're running on all cylinders.
Picking up where he left off on the court in Macon, Paul Bacote is hoping to top that trip to the 5A basketball finals by remaining undefeated on the mound. So far, so good.
I want to go undefeated as a pitcher, which I am right now. 4-0. ERA is like 0.5 or something. Wow. I want to get drafted, but see what happens from there. I got a couple letters.
From?
From I think the Pirates sent me something. the Angels.
Right here we have the captains to this Vikings team. A couple of guys that almost the entire team says they really know how to pick them up, get them going for the games. We have Chris Smith and Brad Hughes. Let's start with Brad. What do you do to get these guys going for a game?
We always get each other, tell each other, get ready for the game, get into it. And before the game, coach always gets us together and talks to us and gets a little prayer going. And then we all get up for get win on three. And
1, 2, 3, win!
Chris, tell me what you like to do to talk to these guys, get them up for the game.
Not so much talk, but rather lead. Lead by example. Come out, have my game face on, and let everybody know, hey, it's game time. Let's play ball.
Chris Smith, I mean, he's not just an emotional leader. He's been the guy that's been our workhorse on the mound all year. He's put in a lot of innings, and he's doing real well.
Chris Smith, he's a pitcher, and he's probably got the best work ethic of anybody I've ever seen. He works hard in the weight room and behind the scenes. He just does a lot to get the team going.
Even Ryan Lawler brings a unique dimension to Lakeside baseball.
My grandfather, he caught in the major leagues for 7 years, Sherman Lawler. Most of his career was spent with the White Sox. He won 3 gold gloves, played in the All-Star game several times, and he went to the World Series once in 1959 with the White Sox.
But at this point, with the Vikings already going 17-3 in their first 20 and ranked in the top 10 of Division 5A, it's really just the little things that need attention.
Some base running things and a lot of bunting, hit and run, and some pickoff moves that we're going on. So we're trying to fine-tune a lot of little things into the game that could be a factor in one run or close games in the end of the game.
Or maybe their success is just this simple.
So you think your team has done so well this year because of that lucky number 13 in your jersey?
Probably has something to do with it. A lot of thought was given to that number 13. So I took 13 on by giving it to one of the kids. So hopefully it'll work for us.
For Prep Sports Plus, I'm Cindy Beaumont.
Look out for the Vikings. All right, thanks, Cindy. Now a story that probably most of you who have a brother or sister can relate to, especially if you two are close in age. It begins with plenty of competition from who does better in the classroom to who's the best on the playing field. Oh, how I remember those days all too well. However, as our Eric Hunter reminds us, like the Mays family, there were those times when we supported each other when we needed it the most.
The boys' single-A track and field state tournament is taking place this weekend. The girls had their single-A state tournament last weekend in Albany. The defending state champ in the boys' single-A high jump is senior Greg Mays from Gordon Lee Memorial High School in Chickamauga. His jump of 6 feet 6 inches last year earned him that title. This season, Greg has had some added competition, sort of. Well, not from an opponent, but from his younger sister, Casey, a freshman at Gordon Lee. Both have been involved in track and field since middle school, and now they're helping each other at the varsity level.
I used to be the only one up here jumping. Like me and my friend, he graduated last year, so I was like, well, I got my sister coming up, so I'll just have someone to talk to and help me work on everything.
Well, I feel that if he wins, I have to win, just because it's kind of cool that we both do the same thing, and that'd just be cool if we both won.
Yeah, I'd say there's a little competition between them. Usually on our meets, he goes first. If he wins, she kind of feels a little pressure to go out there and win too. And same thing if she goes first, he usually feels a little pressure to go out and win too. And they coach each other in practice. They both have a good idea of what the ideal form should be, and they seem to coach each other in practice.
If he didn't teach me, I don't think I would be doing as good as I am.
I'm trying to help her on just getting her explosion. Like, she's not jumping, she's just flat over the bar. I'm just helping her on technique and form mainly. She's got everything else.
All right, let's go over that Mays track and field family tree. Now, their Aunt Jan was the middle school track and field coach. She got Greg involved in track and field. Then he got his younger sister, Casey, involved. Now, they're one of the most successful track and field brother-sister duos ever at Gordon Lee High School.
I've had brother-sister on the same team, but not as competitive as these two. And it is kind of neat and unique. I've been looking forward to it. When she was in the seventh grade, I knew we were going to have a good one, and I knew this was going to be a unique situation, and it is neat.
Casey holds the Gordon Lee Middle School girls' high jump record at 4 feet 11 inches, and she won the Region 6 title in this, her first year of varsity competition, with some brotherly help.
She did hit the bar one time, and he was talking to her, and I was talking to her, and her aunt was talking to her, and everybody was talking to her, but I think she was really listening to Greg.
When Casey came in, I was really
really pleased with the way that she developed. She came in, she worked really hard, had a lot of characteristics that Greg has as far as her dedication and her work ethic. And she, just like her brother, developed her technique very early, and by working on her technique, she was able just to advance just incredibly fast.
Both May's kids run relays and do the long jump. Plus, they attend high jump camp at Appalachian State. Greg, now 6'5" tall, had a growth spurt after his sophomore year. That and playing varsity basketball has helped put him in position this weekend to accomplish the rare feat of winning back-to-back state titles. Casey is also a cheerleader, and now that her track and field season is over, she's doing some more cheerleading this weekend for her older brother. For Prep Sports Plus, I'm Eric Hunter.
What a great story. All right, thanks, Eric. Unfortunately, Casey did not capture the high jump championship at state last weekend. So as Eric mentioned, she'll be cheering for her brother Greg as he competes in Jefferson this weekend. Here are some of the final numbers from the girls' state championship. In the first ever pole vault event, Cassidy Cummings of Athens Christian overcame a double ankle sprain to win the single A title with a vault of 8 feet even. Aubrey Caldwell of Blakely County also vaulted 8 feet to win in double A. Triple A champ Michelle King of Hiram, 9'6". Quad A, Lacey Gardner of Jones County, 8'6". And finally in 5A, it's Danielle Cherico of North Cobb. She vaulted 11 feet. Some records were broken at other events. Latoya Legree of Stevenson County won her third consecutive state title in the triple jump, 41'3¾". Lakendra McCollum of Southwest DeKalb completed the 300 meter hurdles in just under 42 seconds. Rhonda Galati of Sprayberry won in discus with a throw of 154'8". And in the 400 meter dash, Lindsay Vincent of Landmark Christian completed the course in just under 56 seconds. Here are the final team results. For the third year in a row, Landmark Christian wins the single A title big over Providence Christian and Bremen. Crim defends their double A championship. As you see, Greater Atlanta Christian and Pace Academy tied for second. Northeast wins the third consecutive AAA team title ahead of Westover and Westminster. 4A goes to Monroe for the second straight year. Dunwoody was second and Marist third. Finally in 5A, Stevenson with 54 points wins their third championship in the last 6 years. They were followed by Riverdale and Lowndes. Now the story of a young man who has all the ingredients of a successful student, both in the classroom and on the playing field. Brian Salmon introduces us to our Academic Athlete of the Week.
H-A-L-M-A-H-A-F-F-E-E. Hal Mahaffee. His personality is about as easygoing as Mickey Mouse's. Maybe this is why kids get along with him so well. The sky is the limit for this personable student at Bleckley County High School, but Hal doesn't have his head in the clouds.
Well, Hal's Hal. That's what we say. He's always never has a frown on his face. He's always smiling. So when you're having a bad day at football practice or anywhere in school, Hal's going to come up and make it better.
Hal played baseball until his senior year, but chose to concentrate on football. On the field, Hal was a college-recruited long snapper. And if you let him tell it, he needed football about as much as his team needed him. This is where he could release his frustrations in a legal way.
Hal was a good high school football player. He was a leader. He played a lot of positions. At our school, he never left the field. He was on every specialty team, long snap, played linebacker, played guard, did everything we ever asked him to do. He did a great job for us.
Well, I have a passion for football. I've always loved football. Football's always been my first love in athletics.
Hal scored over 1,100 on his SAT in his first take, so you can bet that number will grow. He's also involved in numerous clubs, such as the academic team, the literary quartet, and choir. On top of all of that, Hal is the most popular guy on campus. Don't take my word for it. He was voted Mr. Bleckley County High by his peers.
Yeah, I got voted that. I don't know, you know, seniors, all the seniors voted on it, and they voted me Mr. BCHS, so, you know.
Did it surprise you at all?
Yeah, kind of, but, you know, in middle school, I was voted, like, most popular or something, but I was, like, in middle school, and then in high school, you know, people started changing and things started happening, but I tried to keep contact with all my friends, you know, no matter if they started hanging out with other people, you know, I'd kept contact with them.
Hal is very well-liked. He's quite outgoing. He's often very funny, has good jokes, has an excellent sense of humor, and the kids all enjoy this in class. You know, they get along with him very well, and he gets along with them. good sense of humor is a sign of intelligence, you know, and so if Hal's got that sense of humor, we know that he's got that intelligence too.
Hal's not an angel. It's not like he volunteers his time to kids or anything. Oops, well, I guess he does. Hal teaches once a week at a primary school. With his academic and athletic background, you can see he's already well on his way to reaching his goals of becoming a teacher and a coach.
I enjoy teaching because it's kind of like a fight on ignorance. You know, there's teachers everywhere. You need teachers because what we don't need in the world today is ignorant people.
Not only is Hal Mr. BCHS, he's also a great long snapper. It's a great snap. He's also our Academic Athlete of the Week. Congratulations to you, Hal.
Thanks, sir.
All right, reporting at Bleckley High School for Prep Sports Plus, I'm Brian Salmon.
All right, keep up the good work, Hal. Last but not least, we shine the spotlight on a group of Lady Chiefs who believe the name of the game is defense. Anthony White has the story from Peachtree City.
Expectations are high this year for the Lady Chiefs of McIntosh High School as they stroll through the 2002 soccer year en route to another playoff appearance. They are the Region 4 5A champions for the fourth year in a row and are considered one of the best teams in the nation. So I ask the question, what makes you guys so good?
We just have a lot of talented, hardworking athletes that are really just kind of strive to be the best they can be.
We all work well together, and in the back, we've all been playing together for a couple of years out of high school and in high school, and so we're all used to each other and we communicate well.
I think it's actually a combination of the skill of the players on our team and also just we work really well together as a unit. We're always on the same page, always know where we're going to be, and I mean, we really want to work for each other, so we work pretty well together.
Since 1989, the McIntosh girls have made it to the state quarterfinals or better, capturing four state titles while enduring the pressures of other teams gunning for them.
I don't really think about it that much. I think that we come out here and we're not saying, oh, we're number one. We come in and we play a team directly. We don't say, oh, they're not ranked, so we're not going to play hard.
Once you get to the top, it's hard to stay on the top. It's in something that comes along with the fame of that.
I would say, bring it on. I mean, we're always looking for some competition, and so we can handle it.
Soccer is a thinking man's sport, and believe me, these ladies have the brains to go along with it. The team's average GPA is 3.2 or better, and to make matters worse for their opponents, Megan Bernard is the school's valedictorian, making her McIntosh's first Scholar All-American. So it would be kind of hard to outsmart her in the net.
Megan Bernard in goal has been solid over her 4 years. She is bright. She's the class valedictorian. She's the first Scholar Athlete All-American in our school. And is going to Princeton to play. And out of the five kids back there, three or four of them are playing Division I next year. So,
the Lady Chiefs are ranked at the top of several national polls, and they're recognized as one of the top programs in the country. Defense wins games.
I think that we have a lot of leadership in the back. We talk a lot. We direct people in front of us. We work the ball out through the back and try to find feet. Each person in the back four, I mean, we all contribute something. You know, a skill to the defense. Working well together, communicating on and off the field. We're all friends too, and that helps also.
So we really know each other and know each other's strengths and weaknesses, so we can work together to form a solid unit.
And that's where they run for the roses?
We're going to be the number one in the final poll, which is the state title. So, you know, it's going to be a tough road, you know, a couple of tough games ahead of us, but we're just, you know, take one at a time and see how it falls.
I'm Anthony White, Prep Sports Plus.
Yes, defense is the name of the game. Thanks, Anthony. Quick note before we close the book on this spring season, we here at Prep Sports Plus would like to congratulate the class of 2002. To all you graduating seniors, we wish you all the best in your future endeavors. And now on behalf of the entire Prep Sports Plus team, we wish all of you a happy, healthy, and safe summer. And we look forward to joining you again in late August for the kickoff of the football season. Until then, I'm Jim Giannacchio with one last reminder, if you have some extra time, catch a high school sport. So long, everybody.
Thanks for watching Prep Sports Plus.